Hi, welcome to Girl Manifesto Masterclass. I am Vipul Chitasma and we have beautiful Shireen Sikka.
Hi.
So today we are going to learn how you all pros can look after your clients' curly textured hair. So we're going to learn today haircut, in-salon and at-home curl care routine. Also, I'm going to give you tips and tricks where you can help your clients how to embrace their beautiful curls. So before we begin, I have a question for you, Shireen. Tell me about your relationship with your hair.
So growing up, I always thought that straight hair was beautiful. I always thought that curly hair meant more work, more frizz, more breakage. But now it's different. Now I feel like I want to wear my hair curly more often. I feel like I want to embrace my natural hair texture.
That's great. I think curls are amazing. They have their own personality. What do you want to achieve today?
I feel like I want to find my ideal curl care routine. Like, what treatments should I be doing in salon to reduce frizz and enhance my curl pattern?
And that's exactly what we're going to do today. So, as you all know, when you think about curly hair, what comes in your mind? First thing, dryness, frizzy hair, damage. Generally, it becomes porous. It needs a lot of moisture. Kerastase has come up with a beautiful range that is Curl Manifesto. We have this Curl Manifesto shampoo, which is hydrating, creamy, and it's amazing. The second product, that's mask, extra rich. Curly hair needs a lot of moisture. So this is extra rich mask. If you talk about the technology and ingredients, it has Manuka honey, which is one of the finest honey in the world, and it gives a lot of moisture to the hair. Then it has glycerin, which helps holding the moisture into the hair, particularly for curly hair. And the third one is ceramide, which is for strengthening. We have spoken about shampoo and mask. Let's talk about leave-in products. Cream, which is for curl definition. And we have jelly, which is for hold. And I'm sure when you think about hold, that means you always feel that, you know, hair will be crunchy. But these two leave-in products, it'll not make your hair crunchy. It'll give you nice, soft, bouncy curls with hold and definition. And it doesn't end there. These products are sulfate-free and paraben-free. So now we are going to cleanse the scalp and hair for Shireen by using Curl Manifesto Hydrating Bar. So in Kerastase, I'm sure everyone knows that we use shampoo twice. I've used Concentrate Oleo Fusion for dryness, and I have used Discipline Booster for frizzy hair. So now we're going to apply the mask. Whenever you use mask, make sure that, you know, you emulsify really well on the hair, so the mask will penetrate into the hair, which will give extra moisture. And after this, very, very important tip, with your fingers, you're going to coil it. So we will set the curl pattern. Exactly same way we will continue doing on all the sections. So after layering, minimum 5 minutes you need to keep your mask, because we need to give extra moisture to the hair. During that 5 minutes, make sure you give very good massage and make sure that, you know, your client is relaxed. And when you suggest home care, you can suggest your client to keep this mask either minimum 5 minutes or up to 30 minutes for deep conditioning purpose. So now we're going to rinse the hair, and I'm going to use cold water because curly hair are dry and frizzy. Avoid using hot water. So another important tip, for wavy curly hair, never rub it. Okay, always try and squeeze it to remove the excess water. So wavy curly hair are frizzy, and that's the reason we don't rub it. It will be more frizzy. We squeeze it like that and remove the excess water. So we have removed the excess water. Now I'm going to use this Leave-In Curl Manifesto cream. This will help me define the curls. Also, detangle the hair. So remember, when you're using this Leave-In cream, we need to use on wet hair. So now we are going to apply this product with your fingers. And this is called raking. So we're going to detangle the hair, also penetrate the product just like this. So now, I'm going to present you a haircut specially designed for curly hair. You can see what I have done. I've taken a profile section. After profile section, you take a radial section here. So that means we have 1, 2, 3, 4, total 4 sections. Once you take that, after that, we're going to work on the center of the profile section and I'm going to create my guideline. So generally, whenever you cut hair, you always try and use this kind of comb. But for Shireen, I'm going to use this particular comb. This is wider tooth comb. And here also we have wider tooth and fine tooth, but this is not ideal for curly hair. So we don't use this comb. Why? Because when I'm going to use this comb, I will have my curl pattern loose. So that means I'm not giving too much of tension to the hair, where my hair will get pulled when I cut. In general, on straight hair, when you cut half inch, it is going to be half inch. But on curly hair, if you use normal comb and cut, it is going to be almost 2 to 3 inches. So make sure that we don't give maximum tension and work with wider tooth of comb. But right now you can see Shireen's hair, because of lot of hydration, we have done fusio dose, we have used booster, concentrate, also we have done layering. You can see the curl pattern is quite soft and loose, but it is not going to be like that once we will use diffuser. And also when she's going to scrunch it naturally, we will see the curl pattern back. But right now, because of hydration, you can see slightly softer, it's more close to the wavy hair, and we'll see natural beautiful curly hair. So now I'm going to use wider side of the comb to have minimum tension. Also, when I'm going to start cutting the hair, throughout the haircut, I'm going to ask my client to look down. So I'm going to ask Shireen also, all 4 sections when I'm going to work on, she's going to look down. And my first section would be center of the head. So when she's looking down and I'm taking the same section at 90 degree, when she's going to look straight, actually my section is here, so that's not 90 degree. So we take this section and we cut parallel to your section. After this will be my guide. I'm going to work through the entire profile section. So when I cut this at 90 degree, she's looking down. This hair and this hair, if you see the length of this hair and length of this hair, you will maintain more longer length. Generally, most of the consumers, they have expectations to have nice long curly hair. Actually, Shireen is okay to experiment, but since you know, I would like to show you all medium length curly hair, the haircut which you can do for wavy or curly hair. Now what I'm going to do is take entire section, one of the sides. So either you can take this side or you can take that side. That is your guide now. So I will start with the profile section which we have created as a guide. So either we can start from the back or either you can start from the front. Choice is yours, no problem. Why? Because I have a guideline from front to back. Okay, so I'm going to start from the front and now I'm going to work through taking pivoting sections. We are going to create a round shape. So pivoting section, you take entire the pivoting section by using wider teeth comb and elevate the hair at 90 degrees. Right now, as I move with my sections, I'm going to move. So that means I'm going to travel. Since I'm presenting to you all, I will turn the chair. And work through all pivoting sections. If I don't see my guideline, I'm not going to cut the hair. Because my guideline will show me the direction. You can see as I go further, very less hair to cut. And my last section, the front area. So basically we're creating longer layer. Now always on curly hair, if it's wet or damp, it will be slightly loose. The moment we will dry the hair, it will jump up almost 2 to 3 inches. Depends on the curl pattern. Now Shireen has like wavy to curly hair, so it won't jump that much. But still always think about that before you start the haircut for curly hair. Because when you do long layering, falling here, after drying it will jump up. Now I'm going to work same way at the back side. Also I'm sure you have noticed that, you know, I have not used section clips because I want to keep that natural movement of the curls or waves. Same way at the back side. Okay, the way we have worked on the front and the back side, exactly same way opposite side. So we're going to take pivoting sections. The client will look down and elevate all the sections at 90 degree and cut parallel to the floor. Now I'm done with the internal layering. We're going to work on the external part, which is going to be outline. I'm sure everybody is working on the outline. We have a habit, or we have been trained like that. We hold the hair like that and then we cut it. For curly hair, personally, I would not suggest that because you're going to give tension. More tension means you're going to take off the length and it will jump up. So we will just comb hair naturally and then we will alter the length. So as we have discussed about two leave-in products, one is a cream which we have used before the haircut, which will define your curls. The second, now I'm going to use jelly, which is a jelly curl contour. This is going to lock the moisture. So I'm going to use this now. So now I'm going to use this jelly. This is going to give hold to the curls and also it is going to lock in the moisture. And you can already see my first leave-in product, the cream, has already created definition to the curls. And you remember we had discussed that curly hair or wavy curly hair needs extra care. And for that, we are going to use two products, the leave-in cream and the jelly. When you use jelly, make sure that, you know, you apply through the hair like this. Penetrate the product. Don't get afraid that, you know, the curl pattern will loosen up. We need to penetrate the product from mid length to ends. And now we're going to scrunch it. So one option is that either you leave it like that and let it air dry, or you can diffuse dry. So I'm going to do diffuse dry because I want to show you a quick final look. So as you scrunch it, sometimes, you know, your roots are a bit flat. So what we can do, we can ask client to tilt the hair, take all the hair and scrunch it. So once you're done with the left and right hand side, we will ask client to look up, chin up, and then scrunch it at the back also. And now I'm going to show you another technique. If somebody has wavy curly hair, what we're going to do is take these sections and with your fingers we're going to coil it. So take small sections, coil it, and after coiling entire head we're going to do diffuse dry. So if somebody has very well defined curls, maybe you don't do it, but even on defined curly hair, if you do this, it will be even better. You are an artist, you can decide. So now we're going to diffuse dry. So you ask client to flip the hair down, medium heat, medium flow. Don't use excess flow because hair might be frizzy. What do you think, Shireen?
I absolutely love it. I just love that it's so lightweight and my curls are feeling bouncy, and overall I just feel like my hair is looking really fresh.
I love it too.
You know, earlier when I used to scrunch my hair, I felt like it would become hard and like crunchy, but I like that it's soft. Like it's just feeling really soft and lightweight.
So Shireen, I really enjoy doing your makeover. These are your home care products to maintain your beautiful curls.
Thank you so much. I can't wait to try everything you taught me at home myself now.
Apart from that, I would like to give you a few more tips. The tip number one, don't wash your hair too often. The tip number two is, whenever you wash your hair, use cool water. Do not use hot water. So tip number three, I taught you the gestures. The first one is that, you know, you need to do raking. Use your fingers, detangle the hair. The second is scrunching. Scrunching is very important for beautiful curly hair. So scrunch and set in the curl pattern. And the last one, try and use silk pillow covers, because when you use cotton pillow covers, it absorbs the moisture and also it gives friction, so your hair becomes dry and frizzy. So use silk pillow covers to avoid the friction and have beautiful curls.
Thank you so much, Vipul. I'm going to make sure to use these products and I'm going to remember all of the tips that you gave me so that I can embrace my natural curls.
Thank you so much for joining in for Curl Manifesto Masterclass. Bye-bye.
Bye.